Creo 11 introduces multiple enhancements related to part design, sheet metal design, surface design, assembly design, cabling and routed system, composite design, generative design, manufacturing, model analysis, model-based definition, simulation, welding, and many more. So here in this video, I have selected few of them related to sketching, part design, sheet metal design, and assembly design. So let's see those enhancements. So I'll start with sheet metal design. Now for sheet metal design, Creo 11 offers multi-body functionality. So now you can design the whole part creating new bodies, or you can design the whole part as a single body and then you can split it into multiple bodies. So for example, if you see this part, I have designed this part as a single body, and because of the manufacturing constraint, I will split this part into multiple bodies. So if you go to the flat pattern, this is a flat pattern you have. So this part cannot be manufactured because of this overlap geometry. You see here and here you have. So just because of this, I will convert this single body part into multi-body part. Now to convert it, I have created two datum planes here. Now I'll go for split trim body. I'll select this body. And then as a splitting object, I will select this datum plane. I'll say OK. Similarly, one more time, I'll go for split trim body. And this time I'll select this body, splitting object, I'll select this plane. I'll say OK. So now I have converted this part into multi-body part. Now these three bodies can easily be manufactured. And then you can join it to make it as a single part. Now here in Creo Parametric, you have flat pattern manager. So if you go for flat pattern manager, it will create flat pattern for all the bodies automatically. So you can go to this body, right click, go for flat pattern state and go for flat. Similarly, you can bring it to initial stage. Not only this, you can create individual flat pattern as a rep feature to add in your drawing. So here you can go with this body first, select this body, this is body 2. If you select this body, this is body 1. If you select this body 3. So I'll start with this body 2. Then you can go with flat pattern and bend view both. Here I'm taking name as body 2 flat rep. Similarly for bend view, I'll take name as body 2 bend rep, and then I'll go for create. One more time, I'll go for create rep. I'll select this body, this is body 1. So I have created rep for all three bodies. Now if you go to view manager, here you have all the rep listed. You have body 1 bend rep, body 1 flat rep, body 2 bend rep, body 2 flat rep, body 3 bend rep, body 3 flat rep, and then master rep. Now once you have created rep for all three bodies, you can insert these reps inside your drawing. So if I go for a drawing, I'm creating drawing for all three bodies. So here I will just delete it. Now here I will insert all the details for body 2. So to insert that, go for drawing model first, and here you use set add rep. From here you can add both the rep from body 2. Similarly, I will add rep from body 1 and body 3. Now if you see here, you have added all the bodies to this drawing. Now to add the bend view for body 2, once again go to this and you select body 2 bend rep and then go for general view. Say OK, place it here, go for front view, apply, OK, and then go for projection view. project it. Now the scale is 1:1. So I can adjust this like this. And then to insert the flat pattern of this body, once again go here and select body to flat rep. And then go for general view, say OK, place it here. Go for top view, apply it, and OK. So you have bend view for body 2 and you have flat view for body 2. Similarly, I can go for the next sheet, sheet 2, and here I will add body 1. So I'll go for body 1 bend rep and then I'll go for general view. I'll say OK, I will place it here. I'll go for front view, apply, OK, and then I'll go for projection view. Similarly, I will project it this side, and again to add the flat pattern, just select body 1 flat rep. Go for general view, say OK, place it here, and then go for top view. Apply, OK, change the scale to 1:1. Later on, you can orient it the way you want. Similarly, for body 3, I'll create sheet 3. So you have added all three bodies here with flat pattern. Now you can add all the dimensions. So this way you can use multi-body functionality for sheet metal design in Creo Parametric. Then the next enhancement is related to sketching. So a great enhancement for sketching in Creo 10 was when you go for sketch and draw a sketch. Let's say I will create a rectangle here. So when you create a sketch here, if you modify this dimension, your sketch entity will not move here and there because it doesn't get scaled up or scaled down. Instead of that, when you modify this dimension, the other dimensions get scaled up or scaled down as per this dimension. So let's say I will make it 100. If you modify this dimension, next dimension will get scaled up or scaled down, but your sketch entity will not move here and there. So now you can create any kind of complex sketch without worrying about the shape change. Now here in Creo 11, you have a new visibility option. So if you log these entities, let's say I logged these two entities. Now here you have a new option, logs display. So when you select this, it will highlight those entities which are logged. You can anytime unlock this, or you can hide it by this option. Then another enhancement for sketching is when you import a sketch from palette. Let's say I am importing this sketch. So whenever you import the sketch from palette, you get a random scale here. You never get 1:1 scale here. So now you have a new setting to control that. So if you go to File, Options, and Sketcher, here you have this option, Show Logs. If you select this, it will highlight all your logged entities. Then the next option is somewhere here, Auto Scale Imported Geometry. If you uncheck this and say OK, and if you save this setting permanently to your config.pro, I am not saving this in my config.pro, but once you save that, then if you go for sketch and if you import a sketch from the palette, let's import it. So now if you import a sketch from your palette, you will always get 1:1 scale. So these are the two enhancements related to sketch. Now I'll move to the part. So in the part, the first enhancement is when you rename a feature. Let's say I'm renaming this feature. So when you rename the feature and take a name which is existing in this model tree, let's say I'm taking this name, base REV. So if you take a name similar to the existing name and say OK, you will get a warning here, but it will not come out from renaming. So now you can change the name, and you can say OK. Not only that, if you rename with some spacing, let's say you are renaming like this, and then you say OK. Again, you get a warning. Let's say I have modified this name, but still I have the space. Say enter, again you get the warning. So just like that, when you come out with spacing, it automatically add the underscore here. So the feature renaming is a useful enhancement. Next enhancement is related to surface selection capabilities. So let's say you want to select this inner surface. So if you go with the boundary selection like this, you see it selects so many other things, but now you have a very specific option for that, which is this one, select visible. So if you turn it on and then if you go for boundary selection, it only select the visible entities. So this surface was visible, so it got selected. These surfaces were not visible, so it didn't select that. Not only that, you have some more option added for surface selection. So if you go inside, you have two more selections, trace. So if you go for trace, just by tracing the surface, you can select the surface. Then you have lasso selection. So by this, if you cover an area, it selects all the surfaces there. So let's say I am going for this face and I want to select these surfaces. So by this lasso selections, if I select surface like this, it can be easily selected. Then you have one more enhancement related to these curve visibility. So here in the graphics toolbar, you have a new option, foreground curves. If you add this option to your graphics toolbar and switch on this, you get all the curves visible like a transparent mode. So by this, you can easily select a curve without rotating your part like this. When you turn it off, you will have a different visibility. Then you have a parameter enhancement. So if you go to the parameter, now here you have reported model units. So the model unit parameters are now available as system parameters for part and assemblies. So this is there for part and assembly both. Then you have one more enhancement, which is expand by level and collapse by level. So when you go for collapse all, and then if you use this option expand by level, it will expand your model tree level by level. So first level, second level, third level, collapse all. Same way, when you have expanded multiple levels, and then if you want to collapse it, you can go with collapse by level. So level by level, it will collapse. So these are two most frequently used options. That is why it is here. Other two options you have inside this, somewhere here. So if you go for assembly design, here also you can expand it level by level. So expand it first level, second level, third level, and fourth level. Collapse all. So if you select any one part and then go for this option, it will expand all the levels from that part. And then you can go for collapse all. Similarly, if you hold the shift key and then if you expand, it will expand all the levels from that part. Then you have one more enhancement in the assembly design related to assembly constraint. So if I edit the assembly constraint for this part, you see for tangent, now you have a flip option. So this is introduced in Creo 11. So earlier Creo 10, this option was not there. So to get the desired result, there was a long process. Then you have another enhancement related to bounding box calculation. So if you go to enclosure volume, now here you have two options, aligned and optimized. So when you go for optimized, it will try to form the smallest bonding box. So see here, see the volume. If you go for aligned, this volume is more. If you go for optimized, it gets reduced. If you select this option, say OK, then you can go to the parameters. You see, these are the bounding box parameter. So this is there for part and assembly both, and this will be helpful for packaging the part or assembly. Then the next enhancement is related to dimension handle. So any feature you create where you get the dimension handle, let's say I'm creating a flat feature here and I'm going for trapezoid. So I have so many dimension handle. So if you see these drag handles are normal to this face. And if you see this drag handle, it is normal to this face. So as per your dimension placement, these drag handles are specifically oriented to get the better experience. Earlier, all these drag handles was normal to the screen, and just because of that, the user experience was not so good. Now when you tilt this part, this drag handle shows in a different way. So because of this, it clearly differentiates all these handles, and you can easily understand which handle is what. Earlier, by mistake, we used to drag a wrong handle. Not only that, when you drag it inside, the direction changes. So you have a better experience with these drag handles. So this is another enhancement for the drag handles. Then you have one more enhancement inside the pattern. So now you have one more option inside the point pattern, which is from pattern. So you can pattern a feature using this option. So when you use that option, it automatically takes a point from existing pattern. So the result will be similar to reference pattern, but one advantage you get when you use this option, which is you can go with this option identical. So when you go for identical, it takes less regeneration time. That option is not there when you go with reference pattern. Then you have another enhancement to remove body features. So if you go for remove body, suppose you have a part with multiple bodies. I have four bodies here. So you can remove the body using selected. So this will remove the selected bodies. But if you shift to this not selected, it will remove those bodies which you have not selected. So suppose you have a part with multiple bodies and then you are going for remove body. Then suppose you want to remove these three bodies. So instead of selecting these three bodies, if you go with one selection and go for not selected, at a time you can remove other bodies. So this enhancement will be helpful when you have a part where you have multiple bodies and you want to keep few of the bodies and other bodies you want to remove. So in that case, this option will be very helpful.